existence, of course, is at this time.
Yeah.
tell them how good looking they are. We like to do that every once around here so we can have seekers at the altar. Well, it's certainly a privilege tonight, and it has been a long time since the singing friends have been here, and we're just so happy tonight to have them with us again. Even some of the older, heavier, bolder, old men are back. Isn't that wonderful? And we want you just to enjoy the service tonight, and you can even say amen around here. In fact, we'll be disappointed if you don't. And let's just let the Lord have his right of way as they come and minister to us at this time. The Lord bless them.
In my heart. So let's enter into the service with that in mind. We hope you enjoy the music, but more than that, we hope God speaks to your heart through the words of the song tonight. Here's an old, old standby. I love the words of this old song. Listeners, as we sing, love of God.
Yeah. Absolutely. Some of you know what I'm talking about. I can see the smiles on your faces. There's something that makes it all worthwhile. We all know this next song very well. It's not a new song, but honestly and truthfully, tell us how I feel about it tonight. Listen to Steve helps us sing Just One More Soul.
Sing a song. I can brag on this one because I have nothing whatsoever to do with it. I just stand back and run the controls. Kim, come on up and help Monica and Steve sing. I love the words of this song. Listen as they sing Unworthy.
Grace that he gave.
We just come through what is considered most everybody's probably favorite time of the year, that of Christmas. Speaking of which, how do you like the weather?
Beautiful.
50-something degrees, the last day of the year. I've never seen this in my life. Yeah. I like it, too. We're going to pay for it. Mark my word. January's coming. It's Indiana. Anyhow, I love Christmas, everything about Christmas, as I suppose most of you all do. I have said many times, do you realize that Christmas and Easter are not two separate stories? They're the same story. You see, the babe in the manger didn't stay a babe in the manger, obviously. That babe grew into a young man who went to an old rugged cross for me, for you. The greatest love story ever told. And I know this is a very familiar song again, but it bears repeating. You know, when he was on that cross, he was thinking of me, thinking of you. I love the words of this song. Listen as we sing.
Glory makes the heaven shine.
God's reality.
That's right.
I've heard different people make the statement, if you were the only one in the world, that Jesus would still come and die for you. And I believe that with all my heart. I believe he's just that much interested in you and in me. Thank God for his love. To reach a sinner that's lost, that doesn't deserve it. My, the songs go back to back pretty well. How unworthy that we are. Little key phrase that catches my mind, my heart every time I hear that song is the one that he knew me, yet he loved me. How incredible is that? Knowing who you are and knowing who I am, and yet he would choose to love us anyways. Pay the price on Calvary's cross for our soul. Thank God for that. He paid a debt he didn't know. I owed a debt I couldn't pay. Thank God he spread his arms on Calvary's cross, taking my sin, bearing my shame, praise the Lord, taking my penalty that I can go free. Hallelujah. It's wonderful to know the grace of God. It's wonderful to feel the forgiveness of sin. It's wonderful to know that you're a child of the King. It's wonderful to be bought by his precious blood. Thank God. I dreamed I was placed on an old auction block. I heard voices beginning to bid of a fortune and fame. They've been on in life's game. They were luring my into sin. But then I heard a voice saying, make me your choice, or I thy child that you might go free. Then I saw a man with scars in his hand, and with love he was reaching down for me. No longer an outcast, I've been bought by the King. No longer in bondage, I've been freed from sin, from the depths of sin and shame, to a life that's born again. Now I know I've been bought by the King. Oh, now I've been free from that old auction block. You see, I'm no longer my sin. Since I heard the story of God's love, all of his glory, well, I now have this sweet peace down deep within. Because when I heard his voice,
Praise the Lord. Aren't you glad you're bought and paid for? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Well, we need a drink of water after that song. We're going to take a quick break. Turn it over to Brother Mowry for a few minutes. And if you can stand it, we'll be back up here to sing some more in a few minutes.
Amen. Well, it's good to be free tonight, isn't it? Free from the old bondage of sin. Praise God. We've got the greatest thing this side of heaven.
Amen.
Knowing that our sins are forgiven, we're on our way toward heaven. Hallelujah. Praise God. I'm certainly glad for that Sunday night when the Holy Spirit spoke to my heart in revival meeting. Now, I was born and raised in church. Thank God I was. I've never been sorry that I was born in a pastor's home. I know a lot of preachers' kids that almost cursed the day they were born into a pastor's home. Well, I don't feel that way about it. I thank God for the privilege of being born in a parsonage. But you know, at the age of 19, I had to really settle the issue as to whether I was going to go with God or not. And thank God I chose to follow after Jesus Christ. And I've never, ever been sorry.
Amen.
In fact, I've been places I would have never been had I not chosen to serve Jesus Christ. We're serving a wonderful Savior tonight. He's a good God. He's a faithful God. He's a loving God. He's an understanding God. He's a caring God. He's a patient God. I think I've just about wore out his patience, but he's been so patient with me, and I love him tonight.
Amen.
And we need to rejoice in all the beauties that God and the goodness that God gives to every one of us. Here it is, as I mentioned this morning, the last Sunday of an old year. It's old now. Facing a new year, and as we look back, we can begin to thank God for all the many blessings of this very year. Oh, yes, there's been some mountaintops, and there's been some valleys, and there's been some places that's been pretty rough, but God's always been faithful. And he's going to be faithful as we face the brand new year. Now, you know, it's always interesting when they need somebody to fill in, they always call on the preacher. But that's part of it, isn't it? Now, we want to come to you tonight for an offering. Now, you notice that we didn't sell tickets. We didn't charge you when you came in. We're just going to charge you now. Is that fair enough? And we need you all to help us out in this offering tonight. And God will bless you for it. You know, the greatest thing we can do is give to God's work. Amen? And you've probably heard the little story about the dollar bill. The fives and the tens got to talking about where all they went. And the dollar bill said, well, the only place he ever got to go was church. And I think we'll break that story tonight, don't you? Come, ushers, and let's do our part of this part of the service. And God will certainly bless you for it. Amen. Wonderful. How about you been enjoying the singing? Amen. Well, that was the two people said that, John said. So one thing about it around here, Brother John, we don't have people to lie. We just tell the truth. We all enjoy the singing tonight, God's blessing, and his faithfulness to all of us. Praise God. Brother John Wagner, would you pray for the offering, please?
Heavenly Father, we come before you in this part of the service. We're thankful for thy presence, thankful for the privilege we have.
Yes.
May thy work go forward, and whatever you do, we give the praise in Jesus' name.
But if I were a betting man, I would say that at midnight tonight, you all won't be as quiet as you are right now. Huh? We have the opportunity of ushering in a brand new year and celebrating that, but at the same time, we're celebrating because God's helped us in 2006. Amen. And so let's just kind of, maybe you ought to stand up. Everybody just stand up. That helps your blood pressure just a little bit. Amen. Now, look around. If there's anybody in here that you have ought against, just go take care of that real quick, will you? Ask for forgiveness. Amen. As the singing friends come back to sing for us, let's just open our hearts to the Lord. Let Him have His right way. The Lord bless you. You may be seated.
Several comments about the volume tonight. I'm trying my best to get that rectified for everybody. I've had some tell me it was way too loud. I've had some tell me it was way too quiet. Steve wants you all to vote. This isn't Florida. How many think it's too loud? How many think it's not loud enough?
That's Florida.
Yeah, it's
Florida. I couldn't hear Steve and Cassidy on the first.
It's causing moments.
I wasn't singing.
Or my light wasn't on. Take your back.
John had it turned off. So I want to.
He has all against me.
We're coming to a river called Jordan. I can almost see the swelling tide. Over there, no one ever knows a burden. When we make it to the other side.
Tell you.
not getting straightened up.
You're silent?
No.
You guys want to say something?
You're fine.
Yeah, sure.
I mean, thanks, John's doing a fine job.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Here's a song that's very familiar to everybody, especially this church. And I know you probably heard this song 50 ways from Sunday, different ways you can sing it. We're going to sing it for you anyhow. We'll just let you figure out which song it is. Listen as we sing.
Thank you.
comes by hearing, and hearing it comes by the word. Just open your Bible and read it till God's voice you've heard. Then at an altar in repentance kneel, you'll find assurance that your is so real. For Jesus is right for whatever's wrong in your life. Jesus is right for whatever's wrong in your life. Yes, Jesus is right for whatever's wrong in your life. Just give me
that we sing a couple Christmas songs tonight. Is that okay?
Sure.
Christmas is a few days past. Actually, Christmas time is just around the corner, just a little under 12 months away. Christmas will be here.
That's right.
Some of you are not amused. But we decided we'd try to sing a couple Christmas songs tonight. Somebody requested that. That's not on the platform from what I hear, so it's somebody sitting out there. We're going to sing one Christmas song that's a whole lot of fun, and then sing, no, it wasn't Melissa, not Sister Mom. And then we're going to sing a different Christmas song. Some of you probably haven't heard it. The second one really speaks to my heart. This first one probably doesn't speak to much anybody's heart, but except for Steve. You'll figure out why in a minute. Steve loves this song. Listen as we sing, "The Virgin Mary Had a Baby Boy."
He come from the glory, down he come from
is Steve's favorite song on our Christmas repertoire this season. This next song is one we're not real familiar with, especially those two guys down there need the words. This song really, truly speaks to me. Listen to me sing. What I have been.
Angels appeared unto shepherds, telling the news of his birth. Glory to God in the highest. God hath come down to the earth. Shepherds sought till they found him, and wise men brought treasure and birth. Surely one spoke to the other, we will never be what we once were. Glory to God in the highest. Peace and goodwill be to men. Emmanuel has forgiven my sin. Glory to God, I am not what I have been. Oh, how my heart well remembers the first of this Jesus born of a virgin, carpenter, king of the Jews. Though I was not with the shepherds, and had less to bring than wise men, why to have been changed since I met him? I am not what I have been.
I would not give you anything for this Christianity if it left me in the state in which it found me. See, I don't believe that salvation just makes you able to go to heaven and leaves you as you were found.
Right.
It changes you from the inside out.
Amen.
The story of Christmas is one of that we don't have to live the way we've been living.
Right.
The story of Christmas is the one that says we can change for the better only through God's help.
Amen.
If you're living as you ought not this time of year, I can think of no better time of year with Christmas just behind us, a new year in front of us, to make a change. To make a change in your life. Let God change you. Clean you up. Make a difference. Amen. What a change He's made in my life.
Amen.
It is no telling where I would be tonight.
Yes.
Were it not for God's grace and
right.
mercy.
Right.
I'm sure you could say the same. Everybody in this life will face storms. Christian and non-Christian alike. I cannot imagine facing the storms of this life without Jesus walking right by my side. A song you've heard many times before, an old favorite. Listen to Stephen sings, "Till the Storm Passes By."
Till the storm passes by.
This last song is one of my all-time favorite songs of any song, anytime, anywhere. I tell you what, tonight, instead of introducing, I think I'm just going to let the song speak for itself. A song some of you may be familiar with. Listen to Stephen Sims, of course.
Serving a risen Savior. Well, Did you enjoy this tonight? Say good hearty amen.
Amen.
Amen. I think we ought to book him back in about 13 more years, don't you? Just kind of, I'd only be 73, and some of you'd be 106, and just right on down the line. Amen. Well, we appreciated this tonight, and God used them in a great way. And it's just good to see and to hear the old songs of the church. Amen? Praise God. Hallelujah. Well, now we trust that you all will have a happy new year and do your best to be safe, will you? Don't do anything reckless tonight, okay? I was looking right at Brother Campbell when I said that. Amen. You'll do your best. Wonderful. Amen. All right. Pastor Johnson, I want you to come back up here tonight and close out with prayer. Amen. We want to at least get our money's worth from him, don't we? I was a little confused. When he quit playing, somebody was still playing the bass on that. All that required. Double tracked. Okay. Okay. All right. Let us stand together as Pastor Johnson dismisses us in prayer. And just be friendly one with another and enjoy yourself tonight. And God bless you and thank you so much for coming.
Father, we thank you tonight for the sense of your presence. And we pray that your spirit would continue to go with us. Strengthen us, we pray. Give us grace for every need. Help us to trust in you. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. See you next year.